How you doing, Facebook guys? Dragon Man here. And let me give you a little history about hot rodding. Hot rodding really started after the GIs came back from World War II, after 1945. They wanted to do something exciting. They were bored, and they started building hot rods and choppers. They bought motorcycles, stripped them down, take the fenders off them, take the mufflers off, and stuff like that, make cool stuff. On hot rods here, they took these old jalopies, in the 20s and 30s. They pulled out the four-cylinder motors. They put in the V8 flathead motor, because back then, that was the biggest motor they had, the flathead Ford motor. And they built hot rods. And then in 1955, the overhead small block Chevy motor came out, 265 cubic inch in 1965. And that really made a big difference. In 1957, the 283 came out, Chevy put out. Not only that, but Chrysler made the first Hemi motor. 1956, 1957, the first Hemi motor. Let's see, 365 cubic inch. It was only like 280 horsepower. Then in 1958, 59, they came out with the 290, let's see, the 392 cubic inch Hemi motor. And that really took off with hot rods. Now they had more power, more horsepower, and a bigger motor to build these cars, the hot rods, to make them really go fast. And that's really the way hot rodding started, about 73 years ago. Okay, so anyway, let me just give you a little tour here. We're uncovering all the cars. This is my 28 Roadster. I got my tea bucket over here. These are really, really beautiful cars. You can see that. And I got my 34 over there. This here's my 26 tea bucket. 29 Ford. See, I love these tunnel rams. They really make the motors perform. Okay, over here we got my 56. Over there we got my 49. 1931 Ford. Over there, the 31 coupe. Here's my 56. We got my 26 Ford over here. This is my 28 sedan. This is my 31 Ford chopped and channeled. This has nitrous injection. All these cars are a lot of fun to drive. And what we're doing this weekend is we're putting all the batteries back in. We're taking the covers off because another week or so we open up the museum, and my hot rod room is a part of the tour in the museum. Now you come around here. Yeah, I got my 56 Chevy over here. That's a 56. We got the 55. We got a 57, a 58. This one here is a beautiful 55 Chevy. It's got a 383 stroker motor in it. And you can check that out. Yeah, look how nice these cars are. With the plastic on top of them all winter, it really keeps the dust off. Yeah, 383 stroker motor. Beautiful, beautiful motor. You could eat off it, it's so clean. This is my 32 Ford. This has a 454 Chevy motor in it. See that? It's got push-button doors, push-button windows, and a 454 Chevy motor with a tunnel ram. Two four-barrel carburetors, automatic transmission. 9-inch rear, beautiful car. I have 32 hot rods, 27 of them are registered and have license plates on them, ready to go. Okay, you come around here. This is my 28 sedan. This has air conditioning in it, and check out this beautiful paint job. This is really, really a beautiful car. They're all beautiful. These are some of the gas pumps I have. These are the oldest gas pumps I have. This is a 1928 gas pump, 1917, 1916, 1914, 1932, and 1935. These are some of the oldest gas pumps I have. I now have 78 restored gas pumps. Okay, this is a beautiful pickup truck here. This is my 34 Ford. Hey, check that out. And that's got a 383 stroker motor in it. The bed in the back looks like a bowling alley. It's so nice. This has got an automatic transmission, 350 Chevy motor in it, ready to go. Yeah, check out the bed in the back here. All I have to do is dust these off a little bit, and they're ready to be seen. Okay, well, let's see what we have over here. Okay, over here, this is my 30 Ford, 1930 coupe. Full fended, 350 Chevy motor in it, automatic transmission. This is my Roadster. This is really fast, 500 horsepower. Supercharged. It's got the Demon 4-barrel carburetors on it, 671 blower, 383 stroker motor. This car weighs hardly anything. It's really, really fast. In fact, I got to put bigger tires on the back. Yeah, I've got to get more traction. And here's a couple of my girlfriends. See, this is just the way they would have been having like a coffee break at a diner back in the 50s. Okay, so anyway, let's hear a song by Jerry Butler. I love these Oldies but Goodies. It makes my whole Oldies room come alive. Jerry Butler. Okay, follow me, folks. Now, this is real music. Here's one of my train sets. These are Lionel trains from the 60s. They look like they were made yesterday. These are all pedal cars. I now have 62 pedal cars. I think I have every pedal car they ever came out with. Ford, my fastest hot rod. Check it out. Here you go, folks. 600 horsepower. This car is really fast. 16-inch wide tires, Mickey Thompson tires on the back, 411 gears. 671 blower, 502 cubic inch big block motor, twin 4-barrels, B&M hydro transmission. Yeah, I love to drive these cars. Okay, let me show you my dragster I built years ago. Yeah, come around here. Street legal, 800 horsepower. That's right, it's all street legal. Got plates on it, it's got a radiator, it's got headlights, directional threaded tires. See that? 800 horsepower, blown Hemi motor. It's got 10-inch baffles on the pipes. 18-inch wide Mickey Thompson tires on the back. It's got a parachute, spoiler, and all legal for me to drive around the town of Colorado Springs. Here, this here's my 27 Roadster, and this is a very beautiful car. Hey, watch this. I just give it a little gas. See? 4-barrel, 350 motor, turn the key. How's that, huh? Good. all my cars, they start up. It was pretty cold last night. Okay, let me show you my coffin car. Hey, you could take a picture right from here. Just like the monsters used to have. There you go, folks. It's got a 350 small block Chevy motor in it, all street legal, and a lot of fun to drive around town. This coffin here is over 110 years old. Now see, we got it open like this. I hop in there, automatic transmission, and it's ready to go. Okay, let's go around the other side here. You guys having fun yet? Yeah, we still got a lot of work in here to clean up this place. Here's some of my vintage bicycles. I have dozens and dozens of bicycles from the 50s and 60s. Okay, you come around a turn here. Yeah, look at this room, packed. That couldn't fit another bicycle in here. Hey, check this out. I got four bicycles I bought 20 years ago from a collector in New Mexico that were never ridden. Schwinn Stingrays and full-size Schwinn right here. I bought them in the box. I had to put them together. They were never ridden. Wurlitzer just opened. See all these girls? They're wearing original poodle outfits. The newest one could be is over 60 years old. Over here, I got a setup here. Here's Barbara and Jane. See that? They're taking a break. They're having a milkshake. All my train sets work. These are some of my restored gas pumps. And when you guys get to that show cabinet over there next to the Elvis mannequin, it's got the original newspapers from around the country the day after he died, August 17th, 1977. Yeah, follow me. Picture of Elvis to the public before they buried him. If he was still alive, he'd be 84 years old now. But in my oldies room here, he's alive every day. Yeah, come around the turn here. I got about 600 lunch boxes and over 700 models. Invisible gas pump with the original lock and key. Look at that, 16 cents a gallon back then. Okay, guys. Well, anyway, I hope you like the tour. You guys have a great day, and come visit me. The museum will be open real soon, March 31st, on a Sunday at 10 o'clock. Have a great day.